all this was given to us. And then it's easy for us to forget. Rather than knowledge, forgot, arrogant. They didn't want to be grateful for it. And so Allah sent them reminders. And this Quraysh is the reminder of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was sent as a messenger, first to the Quraysh and then obviously to the entire world. And Allah revealed Surah Al-Fil as a warning when he mentions, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعْلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ. Haven't you seen, didn't you see, how your Lord dealt with the army of the elephant? And then the surah continues, what's this warning about? أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْفَكُمْ حَوِيمٍ. You know, let that plot astray. وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ خَيْرٌ أَبَابِ. He sent birds and rats. That means you need to be able to be counting that, stoning them with these stones of clay. فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ. Until that army was like nothing, just like crops that have been chewed up and left there. This entire massive army, referring to an event that's happened. And an army with elephants, Arabs have never seen elephants. Huge army, innumerable, soldiers, and elephants, and the rest of it have come, and their goal was to destroy the Kaaba. And the Quraysh, who all their blessings that they have is only because of the Kaaba, because they're the guardians of their house. That's why they're safe, that's why they've got food, and that's why they've got all the blessings that they have. And this army is going to come and destroy it, and they couldn't do anything. They run away. And it was Allah who protected his house from that destruction, and destroyed that invading army. Allah is warning the Quraysh that you've been given favors, but those favors are not yours. This is not your house to which you're getting all these, but this is the house of Allah. And when that house was under threat, it wasn't you that saved it. You had no ability to save it. It was Allah that protected his own house. Allah is the one that gave you this favor. Then the next surah Allah mentions, لِإِلَهِ قُرَيْشِ إِلَهِ مِنْبَتَ الشِّفَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ فَلْيَعْبُدُ رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. That because of the faith, the safety and security that Allah gave to the Quraysh. This security that they can make their summer journeys and their winter journeys. They can buy from the south and sell it in the north when the demand is high. And buy from the north and sell it in the south. And make so much wealth. Because of the favors that Allah gave them. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. Then they should worship the Lord of this house. These babies came because of the house that they are the guardians of, not because of them. And the Lord of the house commands them that at least for those babies you should worship me. That you should worship Allah. الَّذِي أَطْعَمَكُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَكُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. If the Lord that fed you from hunger and saved you, gave you security from fear, when everyone else in that society was suffering from hunger and fear, you had safety and security and you had food. And the least you should do is worship the Lord that gave you all that. Yeah, what was their response? The next surah mentions, أَرَأَيْكَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ فَذَلِكَ الَّذِي يَدُعُ الْيَتِيمِ وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ. Have you seen the one who doesn't believe in the judgment? He's the one that shoves the orphan. He doesn't even encourage others to feed. He doesn't believe that the poor should have any share of food. He doesn't believe in giving to the poor. He doesn't even let others give to the poor. The things that they were commanded to do was establish the prayer and give zakat. They were commanded to pray to Allah sincerely and from all the wealth that Allah gave them to give to the people. When the pilgrims come for the pilgrimage, then help them, give them their food, give them clothing, give them what they need, give them water, give them all these things. And then what did they actually do? When it came to God, they gave nothing, not even to the orphan. When it came to the salah, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. Allah mentions woe to those who pray that in their prayer that needless. But they're not praying sincerely for Allah. What are they praying for? Allah hum yuwaadun. Just so that they can be seen. The only purpose of that prayer is so people can see them and say, look at these religious, they're the guardians of the Kaaba. Look how religious they are. Look how pious they are. It will secure their respect in society. And they give them a reason to feel arrogant. That's the only reason they pray. They're not praying sincerely for Allah. So they failed in all their commands. They didn't pray for Allah, they didn't give from the wealth that Allah gave to other people. Didn't do any of that. And as a result, what happened to them? The blessings that Allah gave them, the house of Allah that they were guardians of, was snatched away from them and given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who did uphold those commands. The blessings were taken, they were destroyed, utterly destroyed. And the blessing was given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have inna a'tayna, the letter of Allah, inna a'tayna al-kawthar. And certainly, we've given to you the abundant witness, al-kawthar. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَالْحَرَ إِنَّ شَابِكَ كَالْوَرَى. So what should you do? You should worship your Lord and make a